Guys, I think many of us may be dreaming of getting a quad. So do I. You may have noticed that our channel loves off-road and all-terrain vehicles. And everyone knows that any decent quad is a lot of fun and perfect off-road abilities. But the prices of these machines are so high. BRP, Yamaha, Polaris and so on, all these brands are quite expensive. That is why today we will check the most affordable quads we could find. We'll find out which is the best of them and if it's worth to buy a cheap quad. It's going to be interesting, let's go! Hi guys, as usual it's me, just an off-screen voice, and you're watching review machines. First of all, let's speak a little about the prices. We try to find the machines with the price under $8,000. And if you are going to buy a used quad, I think 4 or 5 thousand is the sum that's enough to find a good quad in decent condition. Well, you pay $4,000 and get a decent all-terrain vehicle for two people, four-wheel drive and quite powerful engine. As to me, it's a good deal, isn't it? For example, if you were choosing a quad of a famous brand, we would pay at least 3 times more. Now I think it's clear about the prices, and now let's speak in a word about each quad we could find for our battle. CF Moto X5. It's considered as one of the best Chinese models. It has half a liter single cylinder engine with carburetor and water cooled. It's a very popular quad with a good reputation. RM 650. It also has a single cylinder carburetor engine with the power 43 HP. It's two-seater, quite a big and heavy utility quad. Stealth Gepard Trophy. This quad is made in Russia. It has 2-cylinder injector engine, 52 horsepower. It's a new model and it's interesting to test it. CF Moto X8. Another Chinese model, this time it's a full 2-seater. It has 2-cylinder injector engine, the power is 63 HP. It's one of the most popular affordable quad at all. First of all, let's see how these quads can go on a usual field. It's worth mentioning that all the machines have almost the same construction. They may differ only in few details. Similar engines and power, the same suspension and transmission system. But it's interesting to know their build quality and reliability in tough conditions. All our quads have had quite a long life, so their weak points are very well known by the owners. And today we will ask them about that. Firstly, let's get the feedback from the owners of CF Moto X5. He knows his quad like the palm of his hand, and he is ready to share his impressions with us. Well, what's the mileage of your quad, and what you can tell us about the reliability? The mileage is about 2000 km. I've been riding it 3 seasons, and in general I like it, but I'm going to change it, because I want more power and bigger wheels. As to this quad, it's really worth its money. The weak point is water pump, I replaced it 3 times. Meantime, our quads are ready to find out who is the fastest. Besides all the others, we will see another quad taking part into this battle. It's Yamaha Grizzly. Well, it's going to be interesting. This time it was a full start by CF Moto X8, so let's do it again. And now everything is okay, the result is clear. The fastest is CF Moto X8, it has the biggest engine. The second was Grizzly, the third place was taken by Stealth Gepard. X5 and RM finished last. RAM seemed to me a bit heavy in this race, but let's ask the owner about this machine. It's my third season with this quad. The mileage is 1,800 kilometers. Quad is definitely worth its money, and I'm satisfied with it. But it's really heavy, because it has two seats and sometimes it's lacking power to keep up with others. The weak points are the ball bearings. I had to repair them in the very first season. But the main disadvantage of this quad is that it's tough to get spare parts for it. Now let's move from the fields to the woods to test our quads in mud. As I've said, the construction of all quads are almost the same. That's why the efficiency in mud depends only on two points. Firstly the tires, and then rider skills. I can say the tires I like today, but everyone has different skills, as you know. Nevertheless, almost all the off-road sites were got through by the quads, except the hardest one, but about it a bit later. And now we see how the machine's moving on the slope. It's worth mentioning that some quads may be easily turned upside down. You should remember about it if you are going to lift your quad and put there bigger tires. A gravity center becomes higher, and that is more dangerous. Then it's much easier to roll over your quad when two people are sitting on it. You've just seen it on your screens. I've been having my Gepard half a year. The mileage is about 1000 kilometers, and I think the main advantage of this quad is the price. It's hard to find better quad for this money. When I bought it, there were some negligible problems, but now they're all are fixed, and I'm quite satisfied with this machine. Now we're approaching the hardest part of our test. It's quite a tough swampy road. I think it may show up any difference between the quads. Gepard is the first. It managed to get through the most part of the section, but then it got stuck in a swamp. A little help and the Gepard succeeded. Then goes a ramp. And again we see that this quad is too heavy. It also got stuck at the same place, but it was harder to get it out from there. Nevertheless, in the end it got through. The next is X5. The problems begin at the same place, but it's worth saying that the quad managed to deal with these problems on his own without any help. And the last one, X8. Yeah. Well, that was pretty awesome, wasn't it? But then we found out that the tires pressure was a bit lower in this quad, so it resulted in a full success. Have you had any breakage of UX8 quad? Of course there were some. Any machine has breakages from time to time. It depends on your manner of riding. My manner is the hardest, that is why I've had some breakages. But the engine is very reliable, and in general I'm very satisfied with this quad. Well, I think we can make a conclusion that all the quads showed us nearly the same results. But if we needed to pick out a certain winner, I would rather say it's X8. But frankly speaking, it's a little bit unfair for X8 to take part in our battle. It's more powerful, two cylinders engine, more aggressive tires, so it resulted in its superiority. If you are choosing one of these quads, the most important question is reliability. As you've seen, all the quads have some problems and weak points, but on the whole they are worth their money. And I'd like to remind that the prices of these machines are about $4,000 or $5,000. What do you think, guys? It's better to buy one of these quads or buy a brand like BRPO Polaris and pay for it 3 times more? Thanks for watching, my friends. Please consider subscribing if you liked this video. It will be many more interesting materials here. Goodbye.